Kajing rai ke Supreme Court ban Ireland ban ti doyong biang hang jela. Kalau nak kajing kemen ya ke serka Meghalaya Democratic Alliance. Haba kren mentah ke sengi sekelap saya kebor. Usumbut menteri rambak ke jela bak Kristen Tinsong ulong. Bakani ke rai jangka kashri kadai bansak ken mau ya ke jela. Ulong bak ke Supreme Court kalau penmi ya ke hukum bak doyong udai jang ke riusimet hang kini ke jela. Bak kalau Ireland ban ti doyong. Tambah haban penbiang shua ya ke mining plan. Bak nak bentah ke ni. Kesarkar geladak ban IT ha artili kisnat kesarkar pedeng ban penkrek ya ke plan. Bak Preston ulong kawai ke kendon ha ke hukum ke Supreme Court kalong banyada ya ke memeriang. Bak ulai itu pak sarkar geladak ru ban lum kemba South Park Kelur na kinong kai duyong ban siu ya ke kuna bala hukum ke Supreme Court ke belong si Park Kelur. Na ke bentah ban penwandur biang ya ke jaka bala ti u duyong. Ha ke bai keliang sembut menteri rangba ulak kam bakani ke kam kalau ulong hadiah ke sarkar MDE kala Shimkia ban bu ka kenhon ning esan an baklan ha Supreme Court ka blala ban bu dien bha ya kani ka kam ulak kno ke sarkar MDE bala ilam do Dr. Mukul Sama kam sim la le AA hendai ka Ukraine he tang kan ya nadu wa khang duyong house lam ajakat sau.
Today I should say it is so historical to the government of Meghalaya as well as to the people of Meghalaya, I should say. Because today morning, the Honorable Apex Court, Supreme Court of India has given an historic judgment, and it is a landmark for the people of Meghalaya. I think all of you know, when we go back to the year 2014, NGT came down so heavily on the issue of coal mining that has happened time immemorial, and they totally banned ultimately. And 2014, 15, 16, 17, 4 years of people suffered a lot. And in 2018, because the previous government, which was known as MUA government, they did nothing. They were just sitting idle on the table and they talk big without doing anything. So ultimately, the moment NPP-led government, in the name of MDA government, we took up this issue very seriously. And we took up this issue, as I said to you, to the Honorable Supreme Court. Okay? To the Honorable Supreme Court. So ultimately, today, that's what I mentioned to you, today is so historic judgment given by the Honorable Supreme Court, where the land has been confirmed by the Honorable Supreme Court that the minerals and its surfaces, as far as Meghalaya state is concerned, belongs to the people of the state, belongs to the owner of the state of Meghalaya. And all these years, as I said to you, everybody, they were concerned, they were so restless when they talk about mining of coal. Because I think you remember the previous government under the leadership of Mukul Sangma, once upon a time, even he submitted all the papers to the Ministry of Coal and to all the connected ministries, which he proposed that mining of coal should be transferred or should be handed over to MMDC. And you know well, MMDC, yes, it is a state government public undertaking, but if you talk about transferring the whole activities of mining, as far as Meghalaya state is concerned, meaning it tantamount to transfer of ownership to the MMDC. Okay. So therefore, MDA government, under the leadership of Sri Konrad Sangma, being the chief minister, the day one he took over as chief minister, we went down to Delhi so many times, unaccounted, I should say, and we met so many ministries, and not only that, we strengthen even our legal expert team as far as this issue is concerned. So ultimately, today I should say that people of Meghala, when we talk about the issue of ownership, number one, the issue of ownership now remains with the stakeholders, or I should say with the tribal people. That is number one. Okay, when you come back to the ruling, to the judgment of the Honorable Supreme Court today, well, as far as mining of coal is concerned, yes, MMDR Act is still applicable. When I say it is still applicable, meaning certain statutory laws, like if you talk about the issue of environment, if you talk about the issue of safety, people of the state has to comply these particular issues without fail. That's why the judgment today says that mining of coal will be allowed, provided mining plan is prepared and then put up to the state government, and the state government will send back to the government of India, and government of India will vet that mining plan, and after that it will come back and people can start mining of coal. This is number two. And number three, right from 2014, the order of the NGT has been set aside by the Honorable Supreme Court. These were the three issues. If you have any question, you please ask.
What about this 100 crore which...
Well, that 100 crores also, what happened was, that 100 crores in my NGT said that 100 crores has to be paid by the state government. Okay? That has to be paid by the state government. But the Honorable Supreme Court, what it says, Supreme Court says that state government, why should we burden to the state government that 100 crores? Now, 100 crores should be taken out from that fund, special fund, already created for reclamation, which is known as reclamation fund. And this will be taken out from the reclamation fund already collected, and this amount will be sent to the Central Pollution Control Board. Okay, that 100 crores. And this 100 crores, Central Pollution Control Board, and that 100 crores should be done specifically for Meghalaya on the issue of reclamation. No, this fund has been collected from the mine owners. You remember, I think that time when transportation was allowed, I think 3-4 times transportation was allowed right from that NGT time, okay, till the Supreme Court time. So that amount has been collected from the coal dealers, meaning from the coal miners. Right now, we let me just tell you, state government is well ahead now. In presumption that we will be able to get a favorable judgment from the Honorable Supreme Court, what we did was, we already engaged with the public undertaking, central government public undertaking. Two agencies were there. One is CMPDIL. CMPDIL. The full form of this organization is Central for Mines Planning and Design Institute Limited. This falls under the direct supervision of Mines Ministry. And the second one is MECL, Mineral Exploration Corporation Limited. Okay, and this corporation is being directly under the supervision of the Ministry of Coal. So these are the two agencies who will prepare all the detailed mining plan on our behalf, and now they are on the job. And within a short time from now, we will be able to bring them, and then we will work it out. We'll start preparing the mining plant on the ground. Let me tell you one thing. No cabinet colleagues knows anything when the NGT ban came in. And he never told us, he never shared in the cabinet at all. That is number one. And then number two, we did not know what was his plan. Okay? And then we used to discuss in the cabinet informally. We used to discuss in the cabinet informally. I used to tell him, why not we go to the Supreme Court? Why not we challenge the order given by the NGT? Why should we just listen to only a tribunal institute? Why don't we do something? But, you know, I'm telling you, there was no response. And okay,
when did the President Kuman challenge?
Last year. We did it last year. Okay. The moment we took.
Oh, which one?
Sorry? Last. Sorry?
Which one?
In the month of May, June. If you ask me this question, I think you would be prepared yourself. You know well, as I said to you, let me talk to you only a simple way. See, the budget of the state government was affected from coal mining ban from 2014 till 2018-19. Just calculate 600 crores per year, it comes to a house. 600 crores a year, you calculate 14-15, 15-16, 16-17, 17-18, 18-19, 6 years, right?